if it's only a dream. Nothing is really what it seems anyway.
Hey guys, so recently I have been told that I remind people of the female version of Sam Sulek. And you know what? I think that's a great compliment. Super genuine human being, and I would love to be the female version of that. So anyways, I was like, I don't have a lot of energy. I'm 2 weeks out, technically like a week and 4 days out from my bikini show. Energy is obviously not really there. So why not do a Sam Sulek inspired mic'd up gym workout? I wanted to do a mic'd up 2 weeks out workout anyways. And I feel like his style of YouTubes is kind of all the energy that I have to give right now. So on the way to the gym, it's gross out right now. It's like 50 and rainy. And the plan is, we are hitting a glute and hamstring workout today. Don't be expecting some crazy, colossal looking glutes just because I'm 2 weeks out from a bikini show. I am like flatter than a pancake right now. I have no, it's like when you're this lean, you have no butt from like your side profile. All you have is glutes, if that makes any sense. So it's just very funny. It's like the definition is there, it just doesn't look like a lot. So yeah, I might be a little insecure during this workout today, but I thought it would be a good 2 week thing to share. It's Wednesday, tomorrow's Thursday. Thursday's always my check-in day. Thursday is peak week check-in. That's freaking wild. And like I said, I'm a week and 4 days because my check-in is on Thursday and my show is on Sunday. So I've never done this before. I think based on what Lauren told me last week is that when I check in tomorrow, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday are probably going to be normal, unfortunately. So we're still really low in carbs, low in food, really high in cardio. My cardio is 75 minutes a day right now, 6 times a week. So the next 5 days are still gonna be really freaking awful. And then I think Monday we start doing daily check-ins, and then we start playing around with my carbs. But I'm gonna save that for my next YouTube video. I'm gonna do a peak week video because I've never experienced it before and I'm so curious what it's gonna look like, and I really want to share that. So that's what you should be looking forward to on my next YouTube. But today we're gonna go hit glutes and hamstrings, a little bit of calves at the very end. I don't know if I'll show that. My hamstring, particularly my left one, I just got body work done for the last time before my show. It doesn't feel great. Not that we're going through the motions today, but I'm not going to be pushing a lot of weight. We're going for like really quality controlled reps, not trying to kill myself. I feel like I'm repeating myself, but like when you're at this point of prep, you also just like, you kind of can't really put out that much. I mean, try as hard as you can, which is what I'm doing, but like your weight goes down inevitably. So anyways, yeah. Might start with a little bit of cardio since I do have 75 minutes. So I might do like a little bit on the Stairmaster and then I'll do a little bit. I might also come back to the gym later I might just get 30 minutes into cardio right now since I need to prioritize my lift more than anything, and I'll finish the second half of my cardio at like 5 tonight. Something like that. So, yeah. All right. I will check in with you guys at the gym. Getting started with leg curls on the machine. I don't feel like doing laying down ones. These just feel better for me. 3 sets of 15 to 20 reps. Like I said, hamstrings kind of were the first thing that really started to get super depleted and like very injury prone for me on prep. So I'm doing 40 pounds. I weigh 105 for sets of 20. Slow and controlled, only resting for like 30 to 45 seconds in between. And then after that, we are gonna do some machine hip thrust. Yeah. Ugh. It's insane. People are like, oh, isn't it so cool to be that lean and like that shredded? Aren't you gonna have a hard time of letting that go? No. Just cannot live like this. I'm like so winded. I did do 15 minutes on the Stairmaster prior to this. That way I have only an hour of cardio left. Only an hour. Only an hour. I'm saying that. 7. You just feel so crampy even if you're like fully hydrated, like electrolytes, EAs, 170 milliliters of water, like over a gallon and a half. And it feels like I've never eaten a banana in my life. Like, I'm just so crampy. Oh my god, I might have to lower the weight. I also can't count my reps whatsoever. Feels like 15. Second set, one more set. Press. I don't even think I've finished my thought, but no, I don't want to say this one because this is just not even a way to live. I'm just a full-on zombie at this point. You're doing 3 sets of 12 to 15, explosive with a squeeze at the top. So once I got like under 4 weeks, my workout plan totally changed. A lot more lighter weight, a lot more technical with what we're doing with my reps to get a lot out of it, since I can't push a lot of weight and handle a lot of tension for a long time. So lighter weight, but explosive. And then squeezing my glutes at the top. So I'm positive on the machine. I can still do 45 and it still felt okay last week. So gonna put this on there. I got 3 sets. I'm gonna do like 1 to 2 warm-up sets and then 3 working sets. Wow, why does it feel heavier? More weight from a working set. I'm a little, I'm afraid to put 25 more on, or like 50, or maybe 10. I might just, let's do this for Sin, just put 10 on. It's weird, like my sports bras are too big. Like, you lose weight, like, at your shorts and your sweatpants are gonna get too big. It's weird when you, like, lost so much weight in your ribs. Like, it's not even a place that you think that you hold a lot of weight. First, that my glutes and hamstrings are literally sore from my banded workout Monday. Banded. Not to dismiss bands, but like, it's crazy to me. Set one is done. Last set, thank God, because I turned the AC on. What we got next? Single leg, cable, kickbacks. We're doing 2 sets. Got 2 sets of 12 to 15. Mm-hmm. sore. I was always doing like 15 to 20 on my off season, and cable kickbacks. A really good way to think about these is that they're like the glute version of, I should do my weaker leg first. They're like the shoulder of your, cable kickbacks are very much so the lateral raise of your glutes. So like, don't stress out about being stuck, like only being able to lateral raise 10, or only being able to kick back like in a controlled manner 10, 15. I feel like you can like always get better at these, like every time you think you want to move up in weight, you can get better. How's my pancake booty look right now? It's gonna flip over here. There we go. I always like doing little tiny like 3 to 5 little pulses at the very top. Really demolish them. Question of the day, do I want to do an hour of cardio after this? Or just do 30 and come back and do another 30 later? Really feeling like I just want to get it over with and then go home and rot the rest of the night. Read my books. Stabilizing hurts. Okay. Oh, I didn't do my little pulses. She is emotional. This is why I've been moving my Zoom calls around, honestly, and working out at this like late morning lunchtime, because I hate to say that I'm like caffeine dependent this far into prep. I'm just so drained. It's the only thing that really, I feel like awake right now. Because every time I was trying to work out at 5 p.m., it just kept getting worse and worse every single week. Like I can do my cardio, the other half of my cardio at 5, but trying to lift then, early 2000s. GHRs. Superseding those two. We don't really have a proper GHR thing, so I'll show you what I'm gonna do. And I'm making it more glute focused, hamstring focused, because my hamstrings are so. Yeah. 2 sets on the leg press, set to 20. Pretty light. It's worse when tall people leave it at the tallest thing than short people leave it at the shortest thing. I can't even. I'm gonna break my back. Alright. 2 sets of 20. I'm putting my little toe beans high and wide so I can get more hamstring glutes. Okay, we got this. Can't be too bad. Reps just I'm gonna lock in for a little bit here. Get through this in the next exercise.
Thank you.
deficit straight leg RDLs might modify that a little bit. Make it more glute focused. Again, hammies, not great. So I just grabbed two plates. Been doing these barbell, but I'm feeling like I don't need to go that heavy, so I'm gonna do dumbbell. Kind of silly to go a whole bar when I can not really load it with that much. So prep. We are doing, let's see, I think it's two sets again. Then we're finishing with calves today. Straight leg RDLs, two sets of 15-20, keep fairly light. Focus on full stretch at the bottom, drive up, and squeeze glutes hard at the top. So, quality of reps. Not too heavy. I'm only gonna stand facing this way. I'm hoping my upper body looks kind of cool right now. Oh my god, yeah. My shoulders are rippling. What we're looking for. So make sure that they're both the same weight. I'm gonna see what it feels like to do them straight leg, but I'm probably gonna change to bent. Also, don't want to be one of those people that's doing like a deficit, like adding plates but not actually making it a deficit. I'm gonna move up. I'm canning the whole deficit thing. So while I'm standing on top of here, I'm not actually going fast. My knee bend a little bit too. Sorry, Lauren, if you're watching this. I feel like I'm gonna tear a hamstring if I do it any other way. Oh my god, I don't even think I did the explosive thing that I was supposed to do. We'll do the full stretch. Can't say I did the explosive thing, so we'll do that on the next set. I'm not gonna show you my calf raises because, I mean, really, what are we talking about? But you know what? Dr. Mike, my chiro. I was like, people used to make fun of me when I was a runner because they were like, how are you like a fast runner but you have no calves? Or like cross country and you have no calves. And I was more of a middle distance person. I just had the mentality to be able to do cross country and I'm just talented at running in general. That's why I'm a hard worker. But he was like, your calves, like below your knees, you're more tendon than muscle. And what that means is that you were just like faster twitch, so you just move faster, like you're gonna be a sprinter. Kind of cool to know. It's like not hate that about myself and be like, oh yeah, that makes sense. Like I was a sprinter more so. Okay. Oh, great. Slow and explosive. Listen, hair. I was trying to face this way to show off my upper body. Yeah. for legs. Just supersetting some calves now. Out right now. Sad, sad, sad. You're so close. You're so close. Plus, I'm really proud of the package we're bringing. Do not feel like I'm not lean enough. So, the confidence we're getting from that is awesome. Hammy tie-ins, looking good from there. My glutes and hamstrings took forever, like most people, to like come in. Last part to lean out. Also, full transparency, I think like most bikini girls, I need to build a lot more density in my glutes and hamstrings so that when I do come back for another show, that like if they're denser and heavier, you're gonna catch that shadow and you're gonna see the tie-ins a lot earlier in prep. So, but you know what, that's in the future. That's gonna be our next phase, our growing phase. I'm excited to share that journey with you guys. I think that's gonna be really cool. Well, we are, we're done with this glute and hamstring 2 week out workout. I'm gonna knock out my cardio now. I don't feel like coming back later, and I also just really freaking wanna eat. So, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Appreciate you guys watching. I don't know if I'm ending the vlog here or not. We'll see how I feel after the hour cardio. I might take you home with me and chit chat for a little bit while I eat, or I might not. Either way, thanks for watching, and I probably will start recording peak week content tomorrow, and that vlog will be out next week. So make sure you subscribe and like this video, and I love you guys so much and your support. Couldn't do without you. Mm-hmm.